Good morning to all. I am Dr. Subbaiah. Today I am going to discuss a very common topic, Tinea pedis and its differential diagnosis. So it is also known as athlete's foot and it's the most common dermatophyte infection. The common causes microbiological etiology are trichophyton and rubrum, trichophyton interdigital and epidermophyton flocosum. It usually occurs in adults and adolescents and it's rare before puberty. The three major clinical types are interdigital tinea pedis, hyperkeratotic tinea pedis, vesiculobullous tinea pedis. Interdigital tinea pedis is the most common type. Here, pruritic erythematous erosions commonly occurs between the toes, especially in the third and fourth interdigital interspaces. The second type is the hyperkeratotic tinea pedis. The diffuse scaly lesions are seen on the plantar surface and sides of the foot. And vesiculobullous tinea pedis, here pruritic, sometimes painful vesicular eruptions occur with underlying erythema. The medial foot is commonly affected. And the fourth type is the ulcerative tinea pedis. Infrequently, the tinea pedis may manifest with interdigital erosions and ulcers, and is usually associated with secondary bacterial infection. Differential diagnoses are erythrosma, interdigital candida infection, allergic contact dermatitis, juvenile plantar dermatosis, pitted keratolysis and scabies. So erythrosma, interdigital scale and maceration on the foot is seen in this picture. It is a superficial bacterial infection of the skin caused by Corynebacterium minutissimum. It's a gram-positive non-spore forming bacillus. And it's the most common cause of interdigital bacterial infection on the feet. And erythrosma can occur in intertriginous areas like axilla, umbilicus or in groin also. It occurs as an well-defined erythematous patches. The examination with a Wood's lamp reveals coral red fluorescence on the inner thighs of the patient with erythrosma. And for patients with localized disease, topical therapy with antibacterial agents such as fusidic acid, clindamycin or erythromycin is usually effective. For patients with more extensive involvement, treatment with oral clarithromycin or oral erythromycin is recommended. The red-brown patches of erythrosma in the axilla are resolved with erythromycin therapy. The second differential diagnosis is candidal intertrigo of the finger web. Their candidal involvement may be confirmed with a potassium hydroxide preparation of skin scrapings from a satellite pustule or skin fold. You can see the pseudo hyphae of Candida albicans on potassium hydroxide preparation with the light microscopy. The treatment topical as well fungal agents like itaconazole, clotrimazole, miconazole and econazole. And the third one is the allergic contact dermatitis. The erythematous scaly plaques on the dorsum of the feet of a patient with shoe allergic dermatitis. And allergic contact dermatitis is a T-cell mediated delayed type hypersensitivity response to an exogenous agent. The diagnosis should be considered in children who have localized pruritic dermatitis 12 to 24 hours after exposure to a contact allergen to which they have been sensitized. The vesicles and bullae developed on the volar surface of the forearm after application of perfume. And avoidance of the allergen is the essential in the treatment of allergic contact dermatitis. Topical corticosteroids are recommended as the first line therapy. And medium or low potency steroids are recommended for mild to moderate allergic contact dermatitis of the face and flexural areas. And fourth differential diagnosis is a juvenile plantar dermatosis. The shiny appearing plantar skin with accentuation of skin folds and fissures in a teenager is seen in juvenile plantar dermatosis. It is an eczematous disorder. It involves the soles that typically occurs in children aged 3 to 14 years. The web spaces between the toes and the dorsal aspect of the feet are typically spared. And it is a self-limiting condition and usually resolves spontaneously over a few years. And avoidance of synthetic socks and shoes and frequent use of emollients are the mainstay of therapy. And the fifth is the pitted keratolysis. So pitted keratolysis, you would have seen this condition more frequently. And it is a superficial bacterial skin infection confined to the stratum corneum that most often occurs on the soles of the feet. and it's most commonly caused by Corynebacterium species, Cryptococcus serentarius, Streptomyces, and Actinomyces keratolytica. It primarily occurs in young adults and affects males more frequently than females. Risk factors include hyperhidrosis, prolonged use of occlusive footwear, poor foot hygiene, obesity, diabetes mellitus, and immunodeficiency. The most common clinical features of clusters of discrete white to yellow superficial round punched out pits and erosions on weight bearing areas of the soles of the feet. And patients often have an associated pungent odor from the rotten odor from the feet. Topical antibiotics are the first line treatments for pitted keratolysis like clindamycin, erythromycin, mupirocin, and fusidic acid. It is applied twice daily until clinical resolution. The interventions to improve foot hygiene helps to promoting resolution of pitted keratolysis and minimizing risk for reinfection. Because hyperhidrosis is a risk factor for pitted keratolysis, treatment of hyperhidrosis is also likely to be beneficial. And the last one is the scabies. The erythematous and hyperpigmented papules are crusted on the foot of a child with the scabies. Here it is managed with 5% topical permethrin. And the management of tinea pedis, topical antifungal therapy is the treatment of choice for most patients. Systemic antifungals like fluconazole are primarily reserved for patients who fail topical therapy. Thank you.